Hi, I'm Gayatri. I'm from Chennai. I'm going to participate in All India Korean Culinary Challenge under the category of non-professional. I'm going to show the preparation of Korean dish tteokbokki, which means rice cake in a simmered sauce. The recipe involves three steps. First is the preparation of rice cake, second is the preparation of gochujang, and third is the preparation of final dish tteokbokki.
First step is to prepare the rice cakes. Let's see how to prepare them. Let's see the ingredients: rice flour, salt, hot water. The water should be piping hot and not a lukewarm. Let's get into the preparation. Take a bowl, add the rice flour, add the salt. The salt is pink in color because I am using Himalayan salt. Add the hot water little by little and keep stirring it, and make sure that the flour completely mix with the water. Knead it into a soft dough similar to a chapati dough. Close it and rest it for 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, take the dough, knead it for a few seconds and split them into smaller chunks. Roll the small chunks into long cylindrical tubes and cut them into small cylindrical tubes of equal length. I have cut them approximately 1.5 inches. Take a pan and boil the water and add the cakes one by one. Close it and let it boil for 5 to 10 minutes. Keep inspecting it in between if it's boiled. Once it's cooked, remove them from the pan and add them to a cold water so that it retains its shape. After a few minutes, this can be removed from the cold water and taken into a bowl. Our rice cakes are ready. Second step is to prepare the gochujang. Gochujang is the Korean chili paste. Let's see how to prepare them. Powdered sugar, salt, vinegar, sesame oil, water, chili powder, Indian alternative for miso. Miso is a fermented soya bean. Instead, I have used chana dal. I have soaked it overnight, cooked it in a pressure cooker, added a few pinch of salt and then grinded it. Then added few drops of soya sauce in it and then mixed it to get that sour taste. Chili powder, instead of Korean chili powder, I have used Indian dried chilies. Take a pan, add the powdered sugar. Add some water. Add the chili powder. Mix them well. Add the miso alternative. You can add water. You can keep adding water when it is required. So add a pinch of salt. When it is boiling, add 1 tablespoon of sesame oil and then 1 tablespoon of vinegar. We need to use rice vinegar, but I have used the normal chili vinegar. Let it boil and the consistency should be similar to a ketchup or a pizza sauce, neither too watery nor too thick. We can turn off the stove and transfer it to a container at this stage. Now we have prepared rice cakes and the gochujang. Let's see how to prepare our main dish, tteokbokki. Gochujang, boiled egg, brown sugar, sesame seeds and spring onions for garnishing, soya sauce, chili powder, water. Grilled paneer, spring onions, rice cakes. Instead of fish cakes, I have used grilled paneer to add an Indian touch. So the preparation is similar to paneer tikka, where we add masalas and fry them in a grill pan. Take a pan and add some water. We can add more water if required later. Add the brown sugar. Add the soya sauce and gochujang. We can change the proportion according to our taste. Add the chili powder. Mix them well. Add the rice cakes. Make sure the rice cake doesn't break. Add the spring onions. You can add any other vegetables also. Mix them well and let it boil for a few minutes. Add a boiled egg after some time and let it boil for a few more minutes. When it is almost done, add the paneer. Paneer is added in the last because it's already cooked. Cover the lid and leave it for a couple of minutes. And then check the seasoning. If needed, we can make any alteration. Check the consistency. I think the tteokbokki is almost done and ready to be transferred to the container. Garnish it with some sesame seed and spring onions. And here comes our Indian version of tteokbokki. Hope you enjoyed my video. Thank you for watching it. Bye.